pero que estés aquí en España promocionando nuestro país, a mí me encanta, me encanta.
Explore the beaches with Adventure Elliot.
This beach is impressive, you guys. It's huge. And it's a surfing beach. Perdón. No pasa nada. Good surf. Buena surf. Good luck.
The same for you.
All right. So yeah, check this beach out, you guys. Like, he told me I have to walk on this beach. Because you can take the road, but man, it's like when you get on this sand here, it's a nice break. It's a nice soft surface to walk on. So here we go, like discovering beaches in Spain. Obviously it's a pretty popular beach, but the Europeans, the Northern Europeans, the surfers come here, and the people who want to be in a better climate, so to speak, and people from Spain, from Andalusia, from Madrid, they come up here to cool down and get away from the Costa del Sol, at least in summer. Really impressive futures here, coastal futures we have, and we have surfers and people out getting their exercise walking. So sometimes these waves and these tides and currents are a little stronger here, so you certainly can face dangers, so to speak. You mostly see surfers here, and so you gotta be aware of things like rip currents for sure. I haven't heard of people drowning a lot in Spain, but if it were to happen, Emilio told me that this is where it would happen, for example. From the rip tides there are, and you know, you see how far the tide comes up, usually it's up to there, and then it goes down and repeats. So the kids here hunt on these rocks. The kids hunt and they find langostinas, little lobsters. Wow, muy impresionante. Y little crabs, check those out. Muy lindos. Okay, gracias. Hasta luego. And here he's hunting, look at him, he's a professional. Suerte! And what a great place to bring the family. I like how just like the coastline is very cliff-like here in Cantabria. And you have these dramatic drops that you saw in the video in the Camino de Santander, the Road to Santander. And it makes for really beautiful beach scenery. Hola. Buena suerte. Todo bien. Que viva Cantabria. Eso. Well, I'm going into the town because I was invited by Emilio for a cerveza. But one last look at the beach here. This is the relaxing part. And the reason so many people are relaxing here is because the access to the town. So if you go that way, you can't get into town. There's no way to cross the peninsula. So you have to come somewhere around here, which is connected to the town. But wow, it's late July. So apparently in August, this will fill up with a lot more people because in August, it's vacation mode in Spain. Most people stop working, take a month off, and come to northern Spain or southern Spain. This town, San Vicente, now is where I am, and it's mainly a tourist town. But wow, it has this little inlet here. It has the mountains in the background. Very, very charming. But all these towns in Cantabria, I guess the best word for them is that they all are charming in their own way. And here, if you want to avoid the waves, this has a green flag. There's no waves here because of that peninsula that blocks it. So here's a good place. And I'm heading to that bar cafe that he told me about, Emilio. Wow, here, Puente de la Maza. Check it out. Oh yeah, let's cross this bridge. Mira gente, estamos en San Vicente de la Barquera. It's a very beautiful little town. and I'm continuing the Camino with Emilio. And you said, de estos banderas, ¿qué son?
Son las banderas de cada comunidad de España.
Sí.
En el centro tenemos la española y después está la de la Comunidad Económica Europea y a partir de ahí cada comunidad tiene su bandera.
Entonces hay 17.
Sí, exactamente.
Vamos. 17. Encima hay un
castillo medieval.
Vale, muy impresionante.
Esto es un pueblo de pescadores que se ha ido creciendo porque se ha hecho muy popular por sus playas y donde la gente viene principalmente a las playas a tomar el sol y a comer. Aquí se come un pescado del Cantábrico riquísimo, principalmente la sardina, la anchoa.
Pero son diferentes que espetos, por ejemplo.
Bueno, es que la sardina del Cantábrico y la del Mediterráneo es muy diferente en sabor. Porque el Cantábrico, a ser de aguas muy movidas,
sí,
la sardina tiene más sabor que la del Mediterráneo.
Interesante. ¿Y nosotros qué hacemos ahora? ¿Qué hacemos?
Bueno, pues ahora vamos a tomar una cerveza o un café. Vamos a relajarnos un poco.
Vale.
Que ya llevamos... Elio llevará ya, ¿cuántas horas? 5 horas caminando.
5 horas caminando.
Ay, cuidado, cuidado. 5 horas caminando y necesita reponer fuerza.
Eso. Okay, guys, I'm here in Bar El Manantial Café en San Vicente de Barraquera.
De la Barquera.
De la Barquera. And eres el dueño, ¿sí?
Sí.
Co-dueño.
Sí.
Con tu madre.
Sí, eso es.
Y él me ha dicho que viene aquí todos los días y él da buen servicio. Y como ves, la terraza está completa, está lleno. Entonces, si tú vienes aquí, hay que venir aquí para tomar una cervecita o café o buen comida.
Las rabas, los calamares, hay
vale.
que comerlos.
Entonces, ¿cómo te llamas?
Yo, Santi.
Santi.
Santiago, sí.
Santiago. Por casualidad, yo voy a Santiago de Compostela. Un placer, Santiago.
¿Tiene?
You see the condensation, the cold, fresh Estrella Galicia, you guys. I've already put on about 15 kilometers today, so. Vale. I thought his tattoos were really cool. Can you show me your tattoos?
Yes.
Son brújulas. Y pues explícalos.
This is la brújula.
Brújula.
Rosa de los vientos.
Sí.
Este es un...
Relojes y números romanos de las fechas importantes de tu madre.
Eso es.
Santi, la leyenda de San Vicente de la Barquera.
Muy bien, hombre.
Well, here we are. He's offered to give me a ride because my foot is beat up. So here we are. We're going on the road of Cantabria. Up there we have a look at the castle, which we were talking about earlier, the history of Spain. These castles, these medieval castles like that, were there to defend the city from the Moorish ever getting here. But interestingly enough, the Moorish never conquered this part of Spain. And so here's the last look at this village. A nice summer tourist village, San Vicente de la Barquera.
Tiene mala comunicación con el resto de España. Málaga tiene AVE, Granada tiene AVE y Almería no tiene AVE. Por eso la vivienda es más barata, por la mala comunicación que tiene. Y hasta el 2025 no llegará el AVE.
You guys, the picos de Europa are in the distance. They're kind of hard to see, but check it out. And we're just arriving to Asturias. Estamos llegando a Asturias. ¿Ahora o...?
No, todavía no hemos llegado. Todavía quedan 6 kilómetros.
6 kilómetros to Asturias.
Almería es la provincia de España, está en el sur de España, en Andalucía, es la parte más oriental de Andalucía, a la derecha. Entonces, es la provincia de España que mejor aprovecha el agua y menos desperdicia el agua. Tiene muchas hectáreas de invernadero y la llaman a Almería la despensa de Europa, porque vende todas las hortalizas en Europa.
Sí, y es verdad que hacen muchos tomates ahí para sí, gazpacho.
Sí, sí. Mucho, mucho. Sí, sí. Estoy enamorado de Andalucía, ¿eh? Uh-huh. A mí, para mí Andalucía es como un paraíso, un Edén.
Sí, sí, de acuerdo. ¿Y cómo sientes del norte entonces?
¿Cómo me siento?
Sí, ¿cómo te sientes de...?
También me siento, cuando estoy aquí, me siento que soy de aquí.
Ajá.
Pero ya tengo como la canción de Alejandro Sanz. ¿Sabes quién es Alejandro Sanz?
Un artista,
sí,
o sea...
tiene una canción que se llama Corazón Partido. Uh-huh. Entonces tengo el corazón partido entre Asturias y Andalucía.
Me siento igual.
Sí, fíjate. Bueno, ahora voy a hacer
eso. All right, you guys. We're going from Cantabria to Asturias. Estamos en Asturias, su tierra. Asturias, otra provincia. Después de hoy voy a marchar por todo Asturias, ya verás.
Que en algún momento de nuestras vidas nos vamos a encontrar y podamos recordar estos momentos.
Vale.
¿Sabes? Y que te deseo con todo cariño que llegues a Santiago.
Vale.
Y mira, una oración, perdón. Una oración, Santiago, bueno, mejor que Santiago es la Virgen de Covadonga. La Virgen de Covadonga te cura todos los males.
Vale.
Santiago también. Pero que estés aquí en España promocionando nuestro país, a mí me encanta,
sí. ¿Eh?
Y queremos que nos vengan a visitar.
Vale. Bueno, un placer, amigo. Igualmente. Un abrazo, un abrazo.
Bueno,
Emilio, era un buen día. Yo disfruté muchísimo.
También, Emilio,
y también. gracias por llevarme, porque duele el pie.
Yeah.
Y aquí estamos en Franca.
En la Franca.
Aquí voy para quedar la noche, gente.
Bueno, que tengas buen camino.
Venga, gracias. I didn't expect that, you guys. I did not expect that. So. Here's where I'm staying tonight, Albergue Triskel. Good afternoon, guys. I'm in a really nice albergue, Albergue Triskel, in a town called Franca. And let me give you a view of what it looks like in here. This is one of the nicer ones. 15 euros a night. And here we go. So this video is going to be me showing you the beach nearby. We're going to this beach. Let's go discover some Asturian beaches. We're in Asturias, which is a autonomous community of Spain in the north. And I'm on the Camino de Santiago right here. Here's the route. So let's go check it out. And it's about 15 minutes from here. So let's go check it out. I'll see you guys on the way at the beach through this beautiful little village, one of many villages we pass on the Camino de Santiago. And it's only 5 p.m., so I have time to go check this village out and then have supper, take a shower, and lay down to rest. Something I really love in the northern part of Spain here is like it has like a mystical vibe. Like it's green, sometimes it's foggy, so like you can see fog in the distance around the mountains. Like the waves have mist that rises above them. There's lots of streams. In fact, I hear a stream around here. Certainly this isn't one of the only beaches like this in the north. There's one of, I would say, hundreds, but they're all unique. And if you love landscapes, adventure, geography, camping, exploring, hiking, nature in general, this has to be on your list. Whoa! Man, this is what it's all about. just impressive, beautiful, scenic. What you see on a postcard comes from this place. Kind of a little hidden beach. I would say there's a lot of locals here. And down the shore, or down the coastline, is Comillas, where you're gonna see tourists from other countries and from other parts of Spain. But they're not coming to these places always because it's kind of in a small village. But if you come out here, you'll definitely not regret it. Wow. This is great. Just soaking it all in, guys. You know, I like both the southern Costa del Sol beaches. It's very hot there. It's more of a party atmosphere, but I also like to be out here breathing that Atlantic Ocean air. To the north of us, you think way north, is France. Even further north, England or the UK. So just to locate yourself. And here is cooler. It's, you know, a modest 70 degrees maximum, low 20s in the Celsius category. Kind of like a dream, honestly. Well, I'm gonna brave the rising tide and go check out what are the beaches like over here. I left my valuables on the beach there. But the truth is, in Spain, you really don't have to worry about anything. Fortunately, my camera is waterproof. She said that the tide is rising rapidly. She's not lying. This was exposed earlier, for sure. It's not that cold, you guys. Whoa! Oh! Oh, shit. All right, we have a secret beach. Wow. Yes. Incredible. Explore the beaches with Adventure Elliot. Ooh. It would be fun to come here during low tide and just walk along the coast, see how far you could get. But I think, for the sake of my body staying dry, oh, here we go. We got another hidden cove. Oh, we got some people, a couple. I'll leave them alone. For the sake of my body staying dry, I think I'm going to end the video here, head back to the hostel, but if you want nature, if you want amazing beaches with these cliffs, if you want to go hiking, if you want to do all this sort of stuff that I talk about in my videos, well, you got to come to northern Spain, you guys, and see for yourself. It's one of a kind, and I highly recommend it. So until then, see you guys in the next video. I'll be resuming the Camino de Santiago in the following videos. I'll see you guys later. Hasta luego. Bonus footage. I'm looking at the most ideal campsite we have here. I think it's right here. So I think here's where I'll end the video. Oh, I'm gonna lay down, take a nap, and see what sea critters come and crawl my way. See you guys later.